Hi everyone and welcome back. Let's see some group of questions. I will just go through them. You can find out the answers. So what is event delegations? How this works in JavaScript? What do you think by AMD and CommonJS? So these are actually module patterns in JavaScript: AMD, UMD, CommonJS, ES6 module patterns. So when we talk about Node.js, all module patterns are CommonJS. When we talk about the ES6 modules, because now we are writing ES6 and we are importing the modules using import export, then those are the ES6 modules. Okay, so there are different ways of writing the modules, because you might also be writing some library. So you can choose either you wanted to allow users to use it, use your library as a CommonJS, ES6, or any other kind of module system. What is the difference between the null and undefined? Good questions. Type of null is an object, type of undefined is undefined. Okay, so what is a closure? We talked about, and what is the difference between map and for each methods? Okay, what is the typical use case of anonymous functions? What is the way of inheritance, like classical inheritance or the protocol inheritance? Okay, what is the difference between call, apply, bind? This can be the questions. Or how do we create AJAX call, and what is AJAX, asynchronous JavaScript and XML, how it works, what is JSONP? Okay, explain the difference between synchronous and asynchronous functions. What is the use of callback? What is the promises? Why the promises are better than callback? Why we should use async await? How it is different from the promises? Okay, what are the different state of the promises? Resolved, rejected, pending state. What is the different uses of the what different ways you can create an object, how you can do the deep copy, how you are doing a shallow copy of objects, right? What are the different ways of declaring the variables using let, var, and const? Okay, other things is how you can extend the properties of an object into another object using object.create, how you can do the deep copy of object using object.assign or using spread operator. All these good questions can be there, but mostly people ask questions about the objects. They will just give you the plain object and they will ask you to play around with this object using map, filter, reduce. Okay, what is a function chaining? Another important question is, so function chaining, like consider you have the array, you do dot map on that array, you return another array. Now you can do the dot filter on that, you will again get a new array. Now you can do a dot sort method on that. So this is kind of function chaining you are doing. Similarly, you can also do the chainings. So chaining is possible if so consider you wrote a class with the 5 functions. Every function is returning this object. So you can do the function chaining. You created the object of the class, then object dot method A dot method B dot method C. This is a function chaining, because method A is returning this object and this object context all the other methods. So you can do the function chaining. That happens in jQuery also, right? A jQuery dot, where you can apply multiple styling methods in jQuery using dot operator. Okay. So what are the difference between the ES class 6 class and ES 5 functions? These are just ES 6 classes are just a syntactic sugar. The inheritance we are doing in the classes is nothing but the same way what we are doing in the function prototype inheritance. What is the use case of arrow functions and why it is being used, and how it is helping us with the lexical disbinding the arrow function? What is the new syntax different from the other functions? Like now inside the class, if you are declaring the functions, you don't need to use the function keyword. Okay, what is a higher order functions? What is a template literal? Okay, all these questions are there to just talk about. What are the different ways of creating the objects? What is it? Array destructuring, object destructuring. What is a spread operator, rest parameter? All these questions moves around the ES6 and ES5. So just keep all these questions handy. These are the basic questions which I am covering.